actually think it might be wisest to do this in a portrait orientation. Just due to, you know, the length of the abdominal aorta, I think things would get pretty scrunched up if we did it in landscape. Oh, I can't spell. Abdominal. Aorta branches. Diaphragm is a great landmark to include in this pattern. So let's go ahead and put our abdominal aorta down the middle of the illustration here. And the abdominal aorta will bifurcate into common iliac arteries. Sorry, my hand really cast a bad shadow there. Common iliac arteries. This bifurcation happens typically at lumbar vertebra L5. Bifurcation of abdominal aorta into common iliac arteries at L5. I'm just going to label abdominal aorta. Yikes. And now you can see it. Okay. So, a very proximal branch of the abdominal aorta is the inferior phrenic artery, supplying blood to the inferior aspect of the diaphragm. Inferior phrenic. Okay, so bilateral, there are two inferior phrenic arteries, so I'll just put inferior phrenics. Then, distal to that would be the subcostal artery. But really doesn't show up as red, does it? Subcostal arteries. And then we can add in one of our large primary branches off of the abdominal aorta. I'm going to draw it as a circle because it really does come off the anterior aspect of abdominal aorta. And it goes anteriorly. So it's coming right off the abdominal aorta. It's coming right out of the screen at you. That's the celiac trunk. Inferior to the celiac trunk is the superior mesenteric artery. Similar idea, large vessel coming up the anterior aspect. Superior mesenteric. Another unpaired branch. Down here, the inferior mesenteric. So these three dots, they represent unpaired branches of the abdominal aorta, and they are going to be the primary blood supply to the viscera of the abdominal cavity. And so what we're going to do is we're going to come up with an embryological tip that's going to help us remember which organs these unpaired arteries are going to take blood to. So when we go back to embryology and we talk about the derivation of the viscera, it goes back to foregut, midgut, and hindgut. And those are associated with these three unpaired branches. So inferior mesenteric is the hindgut. The viscera that formed to become the hindgut, they pulled the inferior mesenteric artery with them. Okay. So superior mesenteric is midgut. And celiac trunk is foregut. We're going to go through what those viscera are as we do subsequent drawings detailing all the branches of these three unpaired arteries. Okay, some more paired arteries off of the abdominal aorta include our gonadal arteries. And we won't really ever use gonadal because that implies that we don't really know the sex of the donor of the specimen that we're looking at. And so we will expect you to be able to tell whether or not you have a male or a female, which I know sounds a bit obvious. But remember that when there are anatomical relations that tell the story better than external genitalia, you won't always be presented with external genitalia, right? There'll be other bits and pieces inside that will help you understand whether you're looking at a male or a female. And so no more can we say gonadal. We're going to now refer to the female condition as ovarian. And in the case of the male, this artery is called testicular. From here on out, we expect you to understand that gonadal includes ovarian and testicular, but as far as we know, every cadaver has one sex, and so we're going to expect you to either say ovarian or testicular. Okay. And then superior to the gonadals, another paired set of arteries are the renal arteries. And then let's actually go back down below the inferior mesenteric. And let's put in the lumbar arteries. There are four paired lumbar arteries. Okay, so the last thing to put up here are the branches that provide blood to the adrenal gland. So let me just put in an adrenal gland. And yes, I know you're wondering if we can use suprarenal as well, and that's fine. Either one works. And each gland will receive three arterial branches. And they're all called suprarenal arteries. So these are the three suprarenal arteries. Off of the inferior phrenic, this is the superior suprarenal. Superior suprarenal is a branch off of the inferior phrenic. the middle suprarenal comes directly off of the abdominal aorta, very close to the superior mesenteric. And the inferior suprarenal is a branch of the renal artery. Inferior suprarenal. So that's the detailed circulation to the adrenal gland. And I did want to come down and finish the story for the common iliacs. Common iliacs will bifurcate. Into internal iliac and external iliac. And you do need to remember this because you will be looking for a lot of branches of the internal iliac artery when we get to the pelvis next week. Okay. So what can I clarify about these abdominal aorta branches? Yes.
For the subcostal artery, is
that
vertical and
horizontal,
like the previous one?
Yeah, so I keep going back and forth as to where I like to put the subcostal artery with reference to the diaphragm. I think it is variable. I think it's most likely, however, that you'll find it inferior to the diaphragm, just due to where the 12th rib is with the floating rib. And I really picture that rib as primarily being below the diaphragm. So I would think of the subcostal artery as being a branch inferior to the inferior frame. So very cool. Let's keep moving on. And drawing number 3, we're now going to get in.